ready to climb Mount Bierstadt, a little over 14,000 foot mountain. It's actually one of the easier 14ers, they call them. That's kind of the name for them around here. It's about 3 miles up and about three and a half back. Any of you guys noticing a little bit, a little harder to breathe yet?
Yes.
Yeah.
You're already way up. And so it's only going to get harder when you exert yourself. When we're this high up, the oxygen level is way down. So it takes a lot more breathing effort in order to sustain yourself. So when we go up this mountain, we got to realize a few things. You're closer to the sun, so you guys have all have sunscreen on. Okay. You can really burn. It feels cold, but you can burn a lot faster up here than you can down where we're from. We're from 1,000 feet. That's where we live, 1,000 feet in elevation. I did bring a few hiking sticks. I don't have enough for everybody. AJ, this is yours. You got to put that back together. If you want them, you might, you know, might be helpful to have them. Okay. You want one, baby?
Yeah, they're helpful.
You and I will share ours.
That's
black
fine.
Diamonds.
That's fine.
Okay. So you're going to twist it righty-tighty, lefty-loosey. Twist it and just put it, usually it's like 135 cm. You want your little bar at the bottom here, this little band to cover that stop sign, okay? And then twist it back to lock it in place. And twist it until it locks good and tight. At least this is how I like to adjust them. So you hold your elbow out at a 90 degree angle, but you want it to be sort of a 90 degree angle for your elbow, maybe a little bit higher actually than 90 degrees. These straps are invaluable when you're coming down. I've never climbed this mountain, so I don't know what it's like, but what you want to do is you want to put your wrist in here, and you want to adjust your straps so that the strap goes underneath your wrist. When you come down, you don't actually hold onto the pole so much as your wrist is supported by the strap.
Okay.
So what Eric will do is put your wrist, hand through the strap, and put your hand around the handle here. And what you want to be able to do is you don't want your wrist to slip too much before it gets support from this strap. That really does help when you're coming down, okay? When you're coming down, you push this in, and I don't even hold on to the pole. I usually just go like this, and this is a little shorter than my pole would be, but, and I lean into that, okay? And it really helps save your toes, your feet, and stuff like that. You guys need, okay. See how my strap is adjusted on my
okay.
on here? You guys see how tight that is? I mean, I can get my hand out, but it's supporting my wrist and my hand so I can brace myself, okay? This one's the one that's checked. Okay, you guys ready?
Yes, sir.
You're gonna look bad here. All right, here we go. You don't know how to do it?
I do.
All right. Bike array, here we go.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I've never seen something rather.
This is growing ahead.
That's amazing. I kind of want a bandana just for that reason.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Take a picture with
a motorcycle now. Morning, everybody. It's David with davidsbash.com. Coming to you with a little hiking video here. I'm here just west of Denver, leading a group up Mount Bierstadt, one of the easier 14ers in Colorado, right by the Georgetown area. It's a 7 mile hike, 3.5 up, 3.5 down, something like that. We've got about 10 of us here that we're going to take up and just enjoy a good view. Yeah, so we did a little orientation with the kids and got them suited up. We're having each of them take 2 liters of water up the mountain, and hopefully we can get up and down before the storm's sort of rolling this afternoon. If you ever do decide to come out here to try this out, one of the nice things is the parking lots have bathrooms in them. So it's a nice thing to kind of do before you head on up. The view here is just gorgeous, even at the base. Nice parking area. National Park Service really does a good job keeping these places in order. There's a little spot. You can register with a logbook. It's good to do that. You know, when deciding to do something like this with kids, you gotta really take into account their activity level and where you live. Our kids live about 1,000 feet in elevation, and they're not used to this. I'm not used to it, frankly. Not this elevation, at least. But you know, that's one of the things. When I did the research, there's really great websites out there, 14ers and
They have a website for all the 14ers, all the 13ers in Colorado, and you can just go there and get all kinds of resources in terms of learning which mountains to take, how to get there. And what I liked about this one was the difficulty was intermediate, so it's going to be a bit of a challenge for some of these kids. But it wasn't too far away from where we're heading, and something we can do in a few hours. And I considered Pikes Peak, but you know, these kids, that's 12 miles one way up Pikes Peak, and that'd be an overnight trip, and we didn't come prepared for that kind of an overnight trip. But this is a great experience here because they can get that experience of climbing a mountain, that sense of accomplishment that is just so important, and it's not gonna suck the life out of them. I'm not gonna have grumpy teens to take home later. We came into a low-lying area, and before they put this boardwalk in, there was reports this is kind of a boggy area, very wet, and you get your boots muddy.
Is this a bog right here?
Well, it's sort of a... just a high water table. It's kind of a boggy area, and so they put this board. You can see they really did a nice job on it. Sure beat hiking in the mud. Can you imagine hiking on foot through this? You can check this out. Yeah, I left my filter back in the van. They say Giardia is common up in these streams?
They said it was common up in the streams, yeah.
Okay.
Because it comes from the animals.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. You get awful sick from that.
Gotta push the silver button, right? Yep. One step at a time, make sure it's solid. There you go. You did it.
I like going.
There's my nephew AJ went with us to the Pathfinder basic training back in May. So he's all ready. All right, AJ?
Yeah?
Where's your next fire?
Huh?
Where's your next fire?
In my pocket.
Let's see your smalls. Huh? Where's your smalls? Where's your smalls?
All around me.
Come on, buddy. 5 minute fire right here.
I don't have my flint steel.
What? You're not prepared. What? What's wrong with you?
Not start a wildfire.
Drink a lot of water. A lot of water. How you feeling, bud? You feeling it in your lungs yet? A little bit, a little heavy chested.
A little.
Yep. You're gonna make it, bud. I know you will. So we've come from that parking lot over there. You can see it's getting kind of busy. That's why we wanted to get out here real early. We didn't even get out here very early, but we got out here early enough to beat the crowd. Since it's one of the easier 14ers in Colorado, a lot of people like to do it. You know, it gives you a sense of accomplishment. But you still want to beat the rush.
Yeah.
Well, they're coming down.
Oh yeah, but
awesome, let's go!
They're like right by the clouds.
I cannot wait to see it.
See, and they got two little ones with them. That's not too bad. Okay guys, if you're watching this, we've been walking through these plants. I'm not sure what they are. One of the things I read said there was some kind of willow, but they don't look like a willow to me. At least not the willows I'm used to. And so, my students are laughing at me. So, because they don't know where I'm going with this. But if you know what this plant is, I'd be very interested in hearing, and you can put that in the comment section. You guys are getting tired, aren't you?
Yeah.
Chest feeling a little heavy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't catch my breath.
My heart's beating so much. Like, I can catch my breath.
If this isn't worth it, I'm going to just quit.
Oh, it's worth it. Trust me.
This non-tap experience better be a good one.
Better be the best one ever.
This will be the best mountaintop experience you've ever had, or your money back.
My money back? What? This is a free trip.
I'll double your money. All right, we got to the snow. Trying to get to the snow level.
Look at the water from here. It's really pretty.
All right, starting to get a bit steeper. Don't freak out, just little steps, okay? Baby steps, right? All you gotta think about is that next step. Those next steps add up and then you're to the top.
I'm not intermediate, I'm a beginner.
you're a bunch of city kids, come on.
Look at the clouds.
You can do it. Baby steps.
I think the company is overdue. I started talking. Oh.
Wow.
There's snow! Woo!
Oh, missed.
Isn't that refreshing?
Woo!
All right.
Okay, that just really
let's warm. Go.
Let's move on. This snow will be here when we come down. All right, friends. Here's another cool plant. What the heck is that? Some kind of thistle.
Yeah, me too.
I won't touch it because I don't know what it is. But.
Make sure you comment what you think it is.
That's my favorite.
Oh, this is the top. What?
Fall summit. Watch out for those.
Fall summit, huh?
It's getting colder though, which is
better. We're going all the way up there.
Yeah. Emily, you could do it. It's going to be worth it.
I thought this was the top.
Come on. Fall summit.
Got it.
Not it. There's the pole. You guys can do it. You guys can do it 1 foot at a time. Baby steps. One step closer. Every time you take a step, it's one step closer.
You can go.
Woo!
Yeah.
Hiking!
Woo! How you feeling, AJ and Nate?
All right.
They're speechless. They're so good.
This is the perfect place to just... God.
That's the idea.
Like when you took us out on that mountain after the night session.
That was really cool.
That was amazing.
We're almost there.
Little snow slide. Look at that.
We totally should have brought sleds.
Oh, sleds would have been fun, huh? Right into that rocky basin, huh? You'd probably die, but you'd have the fun of you'd have the most fun of your life. We're almost there. You're doing good, ladies. Getting some carbs in them.
You should eat too.
I'll eat when I'm ready. You're getting tired. It's getting to be a challenge. They're gonna do it though. One step at a time.
Hiking!
Right, guys?
Woo! Little kids can do it. We can do it.
Yeah,
that's right. We just got over that top of that ridge and follow that over there to the summit. So, you got some of this kind of climbing for a while on these rocks. Those little breaks really help, don't they?
Yeah. Speaking of breaks, let's take another.
Just keep track of your feet, guys. All these cracks and crevices. Keep your feet steady, keep them firm.
Pass us, we're noobs.
It's all right, I'll get up there a little bit, but at this point your ankles are real important.
I know.
This is kind of one of those ankle breakers. So just take it steady. Apparently Sasquatch likes to climb this mountain too, eh? This is, you get it this high and you can start seeing all of these mountains all over. All right, final stretch to the top.
Oh,
Now it's one boulder at a time. Making sure your footing's good, you're not gonna break an ankle. It's starting to hail. Funny, I brought a bunch of teenagers up and they're thinking they can beat an old man like me up it, but they're still way down there. I'm gonna make it though. So I'm just gonna take a nap to this view.
Let me see if they get that message. Hang on.
I cannot believe I just climbed a mountain! So exciting.
The view is amazing.
Beautiful.
How you feeling, Eric?
Oh, so tired, yet so relieved. Relieved, tired, proud of myself.
All wrapped in one, right?
This was so challenging. Let's go up there.
Right here.
You made it.
Woo!
How do you feel?
I feel tired.
That's it? You feel tired?
So tired.
What do you think?
It's beautiful. It's so worth it. So worth it.
Is that worth it or what?
It's so close.
You're so close. Come on, we want to get your picture. It's a team. What's on your mind?
This is so beautiful. Probably not.
All I know is that this is beautiful. This is
insanely beautiful, isn't it?
I know.
I've never done pictures like this so hard in my entire life.
Isn't that crazy?
I see pictures like this in the magazine. Like
I know. You are living a magazine right now. Good job. Woo! Hey, Ray, you made it! We gotta get down before the storms roll in. Think of it this way. The last person is the highest person, which will be the first person struck with lightning. All right?
Woo!
Yeah. No, woo.
I'll take a hit for you guys. Thank you.
You just love us that much, don't you?
I won't.
Here we go, down, down, down the mountain.
I won't.
A lot easier going down, but you gotta be careful. Because gravity is working against you now. As much as it got off just in time. Ominous. Starting to creep in. Well, thank you so much for watching this video. I appreciate you guys bearing with me. My work has just been crazy busy the last several months, and I have no put videos on, but now that we've got some things behind us, hopefully I'll be able to get some more videos out soon. If you ever get a chance to come out here, Mount Bierstadt, I highly recommend it. You know, one of the things with any of the 14ers out here, one of the things you got to really be careful of is thunderstorms. They sort of roll in. If they don't roll in the morning, if it's a nice day, you know, a lot of times they'll roll in the early afternoon. And so we kind of got off before the risk was higher, so that was good. It did rain a bit. It did hail a bit. It hailed up there on us a little bit, but we didn't hear any thunder. And so we pressed through it. I was very proud of my kids. I was blown away that the ones made it. And can't wait to do the next one. I just don't know which one to do. There's so many. But thank you guys so much for your subscriptions, comments, likes, and support. I really do appreciate it. Really appreciate you guys tagging along with me. And stay tuned for the next video. We'll see you outdoors.